It's great to be here with all my hip friends here at the Hippodrome. I was at a disco a few nights ago. I was tearing up the dance floor. I had a nail in my shoe. Oh, boy. So many sexy girls here. Yeah. I'm so sick of women going out with me just to further their careers. Damn anthropologists. Now, when I was a little boy, I was very religious. I was raised Baptist. Once my dad said, "Emo, do you believe in the Lord?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Then stand up and shout, Hallelujah." So I did. And wouldn't you know, I fell out of the roller coaster. He's a kidder. Yeah, I used to pray every night for a new bicycle. Then I realized the Lord doesn't work that way. So I just stole one and asked him to forgive me. And I remember once we were taking a test and I was copying this other kid's paper. And I guess the teacher heard my Xerox machine. And she sent me to the principal, which is like your headmaster. And I'm walking down the hall. I thought, oh, this is horrible. My friend Jimmy went to the principal last week, and he's still not able to sit down. So I'm praying, oh, please don't let him find me attractive. I go to the principal. He says, "Emo, Emo, Emo." I said, "I'm the one in the middle, you drunken slob." He said, "You have to go to the school psychologist." I said, "Why do I have to go to the school psychologist?" So he shows me the petition. And I go to the psychologist. He says, "What does this ink blot look like to you?" I said, "It looks like a horrible, ugly blob of pure evil that sucks the souls of men into a vortex of sin and degradation." He said, "No, the ink blot's over there. That's a photo of my wife you're looking at." You know, when I was a little boy, I had a dog. I called him Stinky. Because he smelled horrible. No matter how often I bathed him, he had this weird odor. So finally I took him to the veterinarian, and right away she says, "Well, he's dead." I'm burying the dog in the backyard, and I put him on the shovel handle, and then I left to get some coleslaw, and I came back and I accidentally stepped on the blade of the shovel, which catapulted the dog over the fence into the street, just as a guy in a Mercedes comes and knocks him 50 feet. And I come out, the guy said, "I swear I didn't see him," and he gives me $10 and drives off. At that moment, an entrepreneur was born. I made $200 that day, you know. Until the same guy hit him again on the way home. I said, "You monster, why don't you kill the third triplet as well?" He said, "I want to see your parents." I said, "I'll need a bigger shovel." You know, I was in bed the other night. I heard my parents in the next room arguing about me. You know, parents will argue, saying stuff like, "Oh, I told you he'd live." You know. They're kidders. Oh, my brother says hello. So hooray for speech therapy. So, thank you very much, and I'd like to apologize in conclusion to all you blokes, both here and at home, who are watching this with your hot mamas. You know, a little later you'll be, you know, and they'll be screaming, "Emo, Emo!" So please forgive me. Thank you for being my friend. Bye-bye.